coach's post-game press conference. It's brought to you by Coors Light.
Lash, what aspect of your team's game has impressed you the most over these last three wins?
Well, I think we've started to build a bit of an identity in the O-zone where we've done a good job of grinding teams out. Even when it doesn't create tons of offense, it's a grind. I think we've been hard at the net. You end up that sometimes your best defense is just playing in the other team's end. That's one thing we talked about at the beginning part of the year. Our very first practice was a lot of being heavy on the puck, and it didn't show itself for a while there, but I think it's starting to really starting to show itself now.
Why do you think it's coming to fruition now? More vets in the lineup, or is it something more than that?
Well, I don't think we have more vets in the lineup. I mean, the one thing I'd say is we haven't had our full team here for sure. We went through a stretch where we had a lot of D out. Now we got we have a full line out right now up front that was I think actually really going. So I think it's good for the guys to keep finding ways to win and whatnot. Why is it showing itself? I just think it's something we've stayed on and we've maintained and worked on it and made important. And even when it wasn't working, our guys kept working at it. And I think we're getting better at it. And we're just understanding how to be heavy in the puck. And, you know, I think Rasmussen's gotten better at it. I think Mantha's gotten better at it. I think De La Rosa, big body, he does a good job of it. I think we've spread the zone better. I just think there's lots of. And then the other side of it, just the net presence. I think we've been way harder at the net.
How much scoring these goals in the last couple of games has done for Rasmussen's confidence?
Well, I think it's huge. I think confidence is everything in this league. I was talking to John Hines before this morning, and we were just talking about how confidence is everything because of how close everything is. Every player is so close. Each team's so close. If you get confident, you tend to go on little runs because of that. And as a player, when you score, it builds confidence. It's just the reality of it, and you start to go on a little run yourself. So I think it's good for him that he's been scoring here. I think his play has been way better in the last little bit. I think he's building as a hockey player, and I think it's he's getting rewarded with it with goals. Now, I would also say he had opportunities to score earlier that had they gone in, maybe that would have built his confidence a little bit earlier, but I think it's a good thing.
You're seeing, I mean, with him, Martin Furk gets a big goal tonight, Justin Alligator overdue for a goal that. I mean, the confidence is building within them and therefore into the team.
Yeah, it builds on it for sure. You know, every player that if you can, I mean, first off, we went through stretches where we just didn't score enough. We didn't win these games earlier in the year because we played good hockey but didn't score. And so tonight, you know, we played pretty good hockey, well, real good hockey, I'd say, for large stretches of it and found a way to score. So, certainly Furkey, that's something he can bring to the table is scoring on that one-timer. And I think Gabby's played a number of good games in a row, so good for him to be rewarded.
Just talk about Glendening and just the contribution he's made this season. I mean, he's a guy who doesn't grab a ton of headlines, obviously, but just from day one, he's probably been one of your most consistent players in what he brings to the table.
Yeah, and I'd say it's for two seasons, to be honest with you. I thought three seasons ago he had a down year, and I think he really refocused himself going into last season, and he's been a physical force, I would say, on a consistent basis, probably your most physical force on a consistent basis over 2 years. I think he's worked at his skill set and gotten better. I mean, the one thing Luke can do, he's a real athlete, and he works extremely hard, and so, you know, through the course of the summer, he's worked at his skill set and gotten better in those areas. He just gives you so many dimensions. He wins faceoffs. He's an excellent, excellent defensive player. I think he ran over his year tonight. He brings that physicality. He's a net presence guy. You can put him in a lot of different roles, and he does a good job. So, he's a winner. He's a type of player you win with.
How much is it, too, you're seeing closer to a 60-minute effort than what's going on maybe the first couple of weeks?
Well, I would say two things on that. One, I thought the first, if you talk about the first three, four games, I thought there was pushes back and forth a little bit. The one thing that helps momentum is scoring, and I think momentum's a huge thing in this league, and when you get scored on, you lose momentum, and when you score, you gain momentum, and it's just the reality of it, and so that's one thing that's helped for sure. I'd also say you have to work to win. We have to make sure that we're our work ethic is what's going to cause us to or be the reason why we win, and I think we've done a real good job that the last two nights. I think Dylan Larkin's led the way on that the last two nights. His work ethic's been outstanding.
I mean, you talked about Dylan the last two nights. Is something different clicked for him, or how do you kind of explain that?
Well, you'd have to ask him. I don't have that answer. I would say Dylan cares a ton. You know, I think he recognizes that he's got to be great defensively. I think we challenged him with playing against the other team's top lines here in the last little bit, in some real good lines, and he loves that challenge, and it just always seems to bring out the best in him. I thought that a year ago, I thought that at the World Championships, and he certainly has done it again over the last number of games. You know, he's played against some great lines, and he will again on Saturday, and it brings out his best competitiveness. And I'd also add, Mohelma does it every night, but Mantha's been real good here the last two nights too. He's really skated the last two nights, and he knows who he's out against, and he's taken it upon himself to make those teams defend him as much as possible.
Your special teams have really been the reason you won the last two games. What's clicked in those areas for you guys?
I guess execution. It's funny, you know, what did we give up, 2 penalty kill goals today? I actually thought our penalty kill was real good. Obviously got 2 shorties too, so, you know, one's an empty netter and one's late against. But I thought our penalty kill's been good, but it just comes down to execution. I think Doug Huda's put a good plan together in those games, and I think we've executed it. And I'd say the same thing on the power play. I think Dan's put a good plan together, and we've executed it. I mean, that's what it comes down to. Sometimes you execute and you don't score, and the last little bit we scored on it.